Well, how do stories bring the land alive? So I just wanted to bring an example from right across the other side of the world, which is of the kookaburra. You know, so I'm going to just tell you a little story about kookaburras and how they wake the sun. And I'm not sure if this is an Aboriginal Dreamtime tale or if it's a sort of Christianised, westernised version of a Dreamtime tale. But I first read this story in a book in Australia, and it happened after I had been out camping on the east coast of Australia, where there's this wonderful mountain called Mount Warning, and there's a rainforest there, and we went and stayed there, and we got there quite late at night, and found this, to get up off the damp ground, we found this watchtower. So there's three of my friends and I, we climbed up into the watchtower and slept out, put our tarps and our sleeping bags up there. And in the morning, because we were there really late, in the morning I was hoping for a nice long lie-in and just watch the sun coming up and over the rainforest. But in the sort of mid, just in the twilight as the day was brightening, there was this sort of from somewhere in the forest. And then there was another one and another one. And this noise kind of erupted, and it's like, oh no, really, do I have to get up? Anyway, so that was the kookaburras waking us all up. And then several weeks later, I read this little story, which basically said that the kookaburra wakes the sun up every morning because one day the sun refused to get out of bed. And it just stayed in his duvet of clouds. Has anyone else felt like that before? So, the Great Spirit, or Baymi, was looking down through the universe and could see, or across, whichever, however you say it, could see that the sun wasn't getting out of bed, the earth was dark. I mean, what would happen if the sun didn't get out of bed in the morning? Any ideas? Any thoughts? What would it be like?
Die.
Everyone would die. It would be dark, everyone would die, yes. It was fairly important to get the sun out of bed. So the Great Spirit sent this kind of the wobbity bird, which was a bit like a luminous bald chicken, so wobbity 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 wobbity, through the universe down to earth to go and find some sounds that would wake the sun up. And first of all, it heard just some leaves rustling. Could you make some leaf rustling sound, please? But the sun wouldn't get out of bed. And then it heard a bat flip flap flip flip flap 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 flap. Do you think that would wake the sun up? So it flew on a bit further, wobbity 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 wobbity. And then it heard a frog croaking. Do you think that would wake the sun up?
No.
Maybe. Yeah, we're not quite. And then it went on a bit further. And it heard kangaroo bouncing along in the dark. And bumping into a tree. That wouldn't wake the sun up either. And so then it heard this funny sound deep in the bushes. Thought, what's that? So it flew towards where the sound was coming from, and there on a branch, dark feathers, long beak, huddled up next to some of its mates on the branch, was a kookaburra, and it was laughing at something in its dreams. It had seen this luminous bald chicken that was just flapping in front of his face. And so the wobbity bird tapped the kookaburra on the nose, and the kookaburra opened his eyes and he started to look and see this wobbity bird just flapping in front of his face. So he started to laugh, and all of his friends started to laugh as well, because they were woken up by the sound. You know what it's like when people are laughing in the next room and you're thinking, what are they laughing about? I want to know. So the sun was doing the same thing. It could hear the sound of the laughter. It peered up over its duvet of clouds. First sunbeam came out through the clouds, and but he couldn't see what was going on, so he had to get right up into the sky in order to see what was happening in the woods. And that was why the sun wakes the kookaburra wakes the sun up every morning. And partly because I want to show off a plain didgeridoo, but also I think it goes well on the didgeridoo as well. And I know that there's musicians in here, and for me, telling stories along with a musical instrument just used to help me relax so much and sort of carry the story. And if I'd forgotten a little bit, I would go, all right, I'll just play my thumb on the piano for a little minute, and everybody will think that it's part of the story, but I'm just trying to remember the next bit. So anyway, here's the story on the didgeridoo. And at the end, if you would like to, after I've tapped the kookaburra on the nose once, and he does one call, if you want to, I can teach you this. This is the how to do a kookaburra. You sort of put your hands together like that, and then inside you're basically going, you just open your hands and the sound comes out. Oh, thanks for joining in so far.